हेलो फ्रेंड्स, यू आर वेलकम टू बे बिंग एन इंजीनियर यूट्यूब चैनल। इन लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव सीन फॉर्म टॉलरेंस कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सी प्रोफाइल टॉलरेंस एंड ओरिएंटेशन टॉलरेंस कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स। इन प्रोफाइल टॉलरेंस वी हैव टू टॉलरेंसेस, प्रोफाइल ऑफ लाइन एंड प्रोफाइल ऑफ सरफेस। लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ आवर फर्स्ट टॉलरेंस विच इज प्रोफाइल ऑफ लाइन। प्रोफाइल ऑफ लाइन डिस्क्राइब्स हाउ एनी लाइन कैन वेरी ऑन सरफेस। It is usually used for curved lines, which shows profile of line tolerance with the curve like this. Let's see with an example. Consider a block like this. Now we will give profile of a line tolerance of 1 mm here to this profile. So we will call out this tolerance by a simple arrow leading towards a surface which we want to control. Here, 1 mm tolerance to this profile means if we draw two parallel profiles 1 mm apart to this original profile, then when actually produced, it should lie in between these two profiles. Here, this is profile which needs to be controlled and should be in between these two red lines. Here, in 3D, it will look like this. This is a profile which needs to be controlled. And this should lie in between these two red lines. This tolerance is not dependent on any datums, but sometimes we use datums. Also, we don't use material modifiers here. And we check this tolerance with the help of CMM machine. Second tolerance is profile of a surface. Profile of surface is similar to profile of line. Profile of line is 2D entity, whereas profile of surface is 3D entity. Profile of surface describes how any surface can vary in tolerance zone. Profile of surface controls all the points along the surface within the tolerance range. We shows profile of a surface with the symbol like this. Consider our previous example. Here, previously we have given a profile of line. Now we want to control profile of a surface. So we will call out our feature control frame like this here with leader up to surface which we want to control. Here we have given 1 mm as a profile of a surface tolerance. Means in actual, if we draw two parallel surfaces to our true profile which are 1 mm apart, then actual surface should lie in between these two surfaces. If we see in 3D, it should look like this. This is a first profile, this is a second profile, and this is the actual profile which should lie in between these. Now you may understand that in profile of a line we were controlling along a 2D only, while in profile of a surface we are controlling along a 3D. Here also datum requirement for this tolerance is sometimes, and we don't use material modifiers here. And this tolerance is also checked with the help of CMM machine. Now we will move to our next category, which is orientation tolerance. In orientation tolerance category, we have angularity, perpendicularity, and parallelism. First one is angularity. Angularity defines the specific orientation of the feature with respect to some reference datum. Feature can be any line, plane, axis, or a surface. We shows angularity by this symbol. Consider a block. Now here we have an angle of 45 degrees, and this is a datum A. We have to control angularity of this surface with respect to datum A. So we will call out feature control frame with leader up to the surface which we needs to control, like this here. Now here many people makes mistake that this 1 means 45 degree plus or minus 1 degree, but it's wrong. Always remember, angularity do not control angle directly. If it's not controlling angle, then how it controls? See here, it's a 1 with respect to A, and here we have a basic dimension of 45 degree angle. If we draw plane parallel to 45 degree in 2D, in 3D with respect to A, and one more parallel plane which is 1 mm apart, So our actual part should lie in between these two planes, which are 45 degrees to our datum. Now clear, this 1 mm means not 45 degrees plus or minus 1 mm. Instead, it means this surface should lie in between the parallel planes, which are 1 mm apart and at 45 degree angle with our datum A. Now here we saw that we have to control angularity with respect to some datum. So datum requirement for this is yes. And about material modifiers, we use material modifiers sometimes. We can measure angularity with the help of height gauge also. As we know this surface should lie between 1 mm planes, we will keep this part at 45 degree angle like this, and we will measure ups and downs with the help of height gauge. Now our next tolerance is perpendicularity. Basically, perpendicularity is an angularity tolerance with an angle of 90 degree. Perpendicularity controls the tolerance of a feature with respect to datum, which is at 90 degree with the feature. We shows perpendicularity by a symbol like this. We will see with our previous example. This is a datum A, and we have to control perpendicularity of this surface with respect to datum A. So we will call out this tolerance inside a feature control frame like this, with an arrow leading to a surface which needs to be controlled. Here we have given one tolerance. Here also, meaning of this one is not 90 plus or minus 1 mm. Here one with respect to A means we will make a plane at 90 degree with respect to A, and one more parallel plane which is 1 mm apart from this plane, like this. Now when our part is manufactured, it should lie in between these planes which are 1 mm apart. Here we can see we need datum to control perpendicularity, so datum requirement is yes. And also we use material modifiers sometimes. We can inspect perpendicularity similar to angularity. Now our third and last orientation tolerance is parallelism. Here for parallelism, we can call as an angularity with 0 degree angle. Parallelism controls how parallel is the feature with respect to our datum. We shows parallelism by a simple two lines like this. Here also datum requirement is yes. And also we can use material modifiers here. We inspect parallelism similar to angularity with the help of height gauge. Here don't get confused in between parallelism and flatness. Both terms are quite different. Flatness is not dependent on any datum and can be at any angle, while parallelism is dependent on datum with 0 degree angle or parallel to the datum. So guys, we have seen all of these points. If you find our content useful, please like the video and subscribe our channel.